The topic for today is natural logarithms. Natural logarithms have all of the same properties of regular logarithms. What's special about them is that natural logarithms have a base of e. Now, we've talked about e before when we talked about exponential functions. Remember that e is an irrational number, and it's approximately 2.718, but it goes on forever and ever, just like pi does. The way that we write natural logarithms is to use the letters ln. So ln of x is how we write the natural logarithm of x. I'm having some trouble spelling today. Sometimes you'll see it written as log base e of x, but we prefer ln of x. And the reason that I write it with cursive letters is so it doesn't look like a 1n if you just use regular plain letters. Like I said before, all of the properties of logarithms apply to natural logarithms. So some of those that we've worked with would be that if we have a number out in front of a logarithm, that coefficient can be packed up into the exponent. So this would be equivalent to the natural log of 4 to the 5th power. And then if we got a calculator out and we did 4 to the 5th power, that comes out to be 1024. Another property is the subtraction, the difference property. If I have two logs that are subtracted, remember that that can turn into a single logarithm where the arguments are divided. So that would be equivalent to the natural log of 6 divided by 13. And then the same thing with addition. If I have two logs that are added, I can combine them to a single log that is multiplied with those arguments. So that would be the same thing as the natural log of 10. Now, a couple of special properties that we want to be aware of for natural logarithms are that the natural log of the letter e, remember this is asking me e to what power gives me e, so that's equal to 1. And also the natural log of 1, which is asking us e to what power gives us 1. And remember that any base to the power of 0 equals 1. So the natural log of 1 is 0. And we want to remember how to switch our natural logs into exponential form. So if we have logarithmic form, we can switch that to exponential form. And if we have exponential form, we can switch it to logarithmic form. So this is like a two-way street. If I have the natural log of c, is equal to a, then that's going to switch to exponential form. Now, the base of a natural log, remember, is e. So that is going to be e to the power of, remember the two sides switch bases, so e to the power of a is equal to c. So we need to be able to switch back and forth because that's going to help us when we're working with natural logs here in a little bit. So let's work some examples using natural logs. So we are going to write this as a single logarithm. And it is going to be 5 times the natural log of m minus 3 times the natural log of n. Now this is similar to what we did with other bases for logarithms when we were packing our logs into a single home and then moving them in together. So remember, the first thing we had to do was pack up whatever's out front. So I'm going to take this 5 that's out front, pack it up to the exponent. Take this 3 that's out front, pack it up to the exponent. So my next step will be natural log of m to the 5th minus natural log of n to the 3rd. Then when we move these roomies into the same apartment, remember that positive roomies live upstairs, negative roomies live downstairs. So we're going to have a single natural log with an upstairs that has m to the 5th and a downstairs that has n to the 3rd. And you can have parentheses around the m to the 5th over n to the 3rd, but they're not 100% necessary. The next skill we're going to work on is solving equations. And we're going to have several examples of this. Looks like 4. So example 1. Our equation is natural log of x equals negative 2. Our strategy on this equation is going to be to convert to exponential form. The reason we're going to use this strategy is because we have our x inside a logarithm, and the only way to get it out of the logarithm is to convert it to exponential form. So if you go back up to your instructions up here, we're going to switch natural log of x equals negative 2 into its exponential form. So we'll keep the base the base. The base is e. And then the negative 2 and the x switch sides. So it's e to the negative 2 equals x. Now, if you need a decimal form for your answer, you'll need to use your calculator to do that. And remember, there's a couple places you can find that e button. It's right here. In little blue letters, it says e to the x, and right here in little blue letters, it just says e. So you can use either of those. If I do e, which is the second for divide, and then I do 2 to the power of negative 2, enter, that gives me x is approximately equal to 0.135. So pay attention to if your question is asking you for an exact answer, which would be this one, e to the negative 2 is exact, or a decimal approximation, which would be 0.135, and then also pay attention to how many decimal places it wants you to get for your answer. Okay, let's do a little bit more challenging solve the equation example. So we have the natural log of the quantity 4x minus 1 equals 36. Now notice again that our x is inside the logarithm. So we're going to need to convert to exponential form again. The base is going to be e because it's a natural log. And we're going to raise it to the power of 36. And then it equals whatever's in the argument of the log, so it's going to be equal to 4x minus 1. Then we need to just go through and solve for x. So our next step will be to add 1 to both sides. Now e to the 36 and plus 1 cannot be combined. So we're just going to put them by each other in addition. E to the 36 plus 1 equals 4x. And then just divide both sides by 4 to get x by itself. So if you're looking for an exact answer, it's going to be e to the 36th power plus 1 divided by 4. If you need a decimal approximation, we're going to have to do that in our calculator. So we would need e to the 36th power, e to the 36th power, and then I'm going to add 1, and then I'm going to divide by 4. And that gives me scientific notation. It's a big number, 1.078. This e here means, that capital E, means times 10 to the, and then 15, so it would be times 10 to the 15th power. Example 3. Let's solve the equation e to the x equals 18. Now this time our variable is up in the exponent. So we're going to need to use a different strategy. The strategy we're going to use when we have a variable up in the exponent is that we're going to take the natural log of both sides. It's kind of like taking the square root of both sides, but it's a natural log. So we'll have natural log of e to the x equals natural log of 18. And we still have that variable up in the exponent, but now we can use the property of logarithms that allows us to bring the exponent out to the front. So now we have x times the natural log of e equals the natural log of 18. Now remember those properties that we started out with, those special ones. That natural log of e is one of the special ones, remember from over here. Natural log of e is equal to 1. So I can replace natural log of e with a 1. So x times 1 equals natural log of 18. And that's just x equals natural log of 18. So this would be my exact answer. And if I need a decimal approximation, we'll go to the calculator. And the natural log button is next to the 4. It's right here. It's a little hard to see because mine is worn off. We take the natural log of 18, enter, and we'd get x is approximately 2.890, depending on what they want you to round to. This is our last solving equations example. We still have other stuff to do, but this will be our last solve the equation. E to the x plus 1 equals 30. Now this problem looks similar, and we're going to use the same strategy. It's just a little bit more complicated because we have the plus 1 there. But we're still going to take the natural log of both sides. So we have natural log of e to the x plus 1 equals natural log of 30. And then we're still going to bring this exponent down to the front. Make sure you keep the x plus 1 together. So we're going to group it in a parenthesis. X plus 1 times natural log of e equals natural log of 30. Now remember, natural log of e is 1. So that's really just x plus 1 times 1, which simplifies to x plus 1 equals natural log of 30. And then subtract 1 from both sides. So we get x equals, now this natural log of 30, that's a mathematical operation that we would have to do before we do subtraction. So it's not going to be natural log of 29. It's going to stay natural log of 30, subtract 1. That would be our exact answer. If we need a decimal approximation, we'll go to the calculator and do natural log of 30, enter, subtract 1, enter, and we get 2.401. I think I have enough space to fit this last little example right down here. It's going to be squishy. But our instructions are to simplify the expression. And it looks like this. Natural log of e to the 83rd. Hopefully you're starting to recognize that if I have an exponent with a log, I can bring that power out to the front so that now I have 83 times the natural log of e. And I'm sure you're remembering that natural log of e equals 1. So that's like 83 times 1, which is going to leave us a final answer of 83. Okay, we're almost done, guys. Almost done. We have one example left. It's going to be a story problem. So what I'm going to need you to do is pause this video and copy down the words to go with the story problem. So go ahead and pause your video, get this copied down, and then when you start it back up, we will solve it. Okay. By measuring the amount of carbon-14 in an object, a paleontologist can determine its approximate age. Below is a model for one specific artifact showing the amount of carbon-14 as a function of time. So here's our model. They've already given us the equation. So all we really have to do is figure out what all the letters stand for and go from there. So I'll tell you what they are. This Y is the amount of carbon-14 after T years. A is the original amount of carbon-14. E is an irrational number, so we don't need to worry too much about that. We're just going to use our calculator for it. And T is the amount of time that has passed. This negative 0.00012, that's what we call a rate of decay. And it's going to be given to you in this problem, although in future classes you'll have to be able to solve for that as well. We won't worry about that today. Here's the problem we're supposed to be solving. In 2013, a fossil was found that contains 25% of its original carbon-14. What is the approximate age of the fossil to the nearest integer? So, this 25% of its original carbon-14 is how much is in there after time has passed. So this is our y. Our y is equal to 25% of the original. Well, we have a letter for the original amount. It's A. And we know that in math, of means we're going to multiply. And 25% we know is like 0.25. So this is like saying y is equal to 0.25 times A. So if we use 0.25 times A to replace Y, that's going to give us 0.25A equals, we don't know how much was originally there, but we can use the letter A, and then times E to the negative 0.00012T. This looks a little bit crazy right now, but what we can do is divide both sides by A. And that's going to allow us to cancel the A's here and cancel the A's here so that I'm left with 0.25 equals E to the negative 0.00012T. Now this looks a bit similar to problems that we solved on the solving equations part. Our variable is stuck up in the exponent, and so our strategy when we had that happen was to take the natural log of both sides. So we'll take the natural log of 0.25, so that gives us natural log of 0.25, and the natural log of e to the negative 0.00012t. And remember that the reason that we use that strategy is so we can bring this exponent out to the front and turn it into multiplication. So now we have natural log of 0.25 equals negative 0.00012t times the natural log of e. Remember that the natural log of e is 1. So now I basically have natural log of 0.25 equals negative 0.00012t, and then times 1 doesn't matter. So this is really the equation I'm working with. And then to solve for t, I'll just divide both sides by negative 0.00012. So now I'm going to divide by negative 0.00012, divide by negative 0.00012. And so my exact answer would be that t equals natural log of 0.25 divided by negative 0.00012. Now we don't want to leave an exact answer, especially in a story problem. We are going to go ahead and get a decimal approximation for that. So we'll want to be real careful in our calculator when we do this. We're going to do the natural log of 0.25. Go ahead and hit enter, and then divide by negative 0.00012. That gives me 11552.45. And so we're going to round this to the nearest integer, it said. So we're going to round it to 11552. So we would say that the fossil is 11552 years old.